Are these...
graves? Sure. Be uncivilized not to bury them.
Besides, it's good for the soil.
Come on back inside. I think I might be able to rustle you up some sandwiches.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
We gotta go now.
They killed all these people.
They didn't just kill them, they ate them.
Her hands were shaking.
Too much human meat. Let's go.
I found some meat. I hope you're hungry.
No. No, thank you.
Well, we gotta be going.
So soon?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Are you sure you won't stay?
I'm sure. I'm very sure. Put the gun down. Solara, you can take this. Open the door for us, please. Solara, thank you for the tea.
Thank you for the tea.
Thank you so much for the tea.
This is the book of 2 Esdras, chapter 16. Verse 19, behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are set as scourges for amendment.
Call Allah.
Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushah Ba'ashim Rakakadash.
Rakatha Wah Brakatham to the elect and the 1/3 of the children of Israel. Double honors to the teachers and the head apostles of the great stone Ruel. Peace and salutations to the Archim of pushing out this word with Jewish sincerity. Also, Rakatha to the Akwafim who are listening as well. This is Prophets in Babylon, Tampa Bay, Florida. My name is Brother Daniel, I'm by my side.
Brother Ashar.
All right. So, we're going to bring out a class about cannibalism, man. Kuru, the Kuru disease that's about to come back in these last days. All right?
Come on. Before the brother gets into that definition of Kuru, mm-hmm. I want to bring out this scripture again. 2 Esdras chapter 16, verse 19. It says, behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are set as scourges for amendment. Scourges goes into a person, thing that causes great trouble or suffering. And also amendment is improvement and correction. All right. So these things that are coming onto the earth is what the Most High, Yahweh Bashem Yahshua, is going to send. And we're focusing on the famine, man, and the plague, because Kuru is a disease. But going down to verse 20, it says, but all these things, they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourges. So they won't be mindful or turn away from their wickedness. They're going to continue being wicked in this wicked system, man. This is full of sin, man. This kingdom is full of sin. So that goes into the 2/3, man, of the Israelites. And the brother can bring out this disease.
And this disease was discovered in the early in the late 20th, about mid 20th century, around the 1960s. Okay, so this disease is going to come back, all right, and we're about to enter into a famine within our lifetime, where there's going to be no more food, you know, lack of bread, you know, in these stores, and the people are going to lack food in their houses. And they're gonna start killing each other for food, man. But let's bring out the definition of the Kuru disease. It's K-U-R-U. All right, Kuru is, this is from the Wikipedia website. It says Kuru is a rare, incurable, and fatal neurodegenerative disorder that was formerly common among the four people of Papua New Guinea. Kuru is a form of transmissible spongiform encephalopathy caused by the transmission of abnormally folded proteins, prions, which leads to symptoms such as tremors and loss of coordination up from neural degeneration. All right, so let's get the neurological disorder. So when these people did these people were into heavy witchcraft, and what they did was, when their relatives die, they eat the corpse of that relative, you know, to have a piece of, you know, of their family member inside of them. It was a weird ritual that they did. And when they ate the dead corpse of those people, it started to mess up their neural system within their body, causing them to have neurological disorders. So let's get that real quick. A neurological disorder is any disorder of the nervous system, structural, biochemical, or electrical abnormalities in the brain, spinal cord, or other nerves can result in a range of symptoms. Examples of symptoms include paralysis, muscle weakness, poor coordination, loss of sensation, seizures, confusion, pain, and altered levels of consciousness. All right, and a perfect example of a clip, you know, a well-known clip called The Book of Eli, okay, where people were eating each other to survive, all right? And that one scene where Eli, you know, went inside the store, and the man said, "Let me see your hands." And once he pulled out his hands, you know, he said, "I'm not one of them," meaning he wasn't a cannibal. So when you eat people, it's gonna cause a neurological disorder within your body. And it's going, and plus, people who eat other people, they don't live long. These people who were in that little tribal witchcraft stuff in New Guinea, they didn't live that long, because eating the dead corpse of eating a dead corpse can destroy you very fast. It can mess with your brain. It can mess with anything in your body. And they also call it the laughing disease, because before they died, they laugh as they're, you know, passing away, because like their body is shaking and they can't stay still. They can't stand up. Someone has to hold up their head. Someone has to stand them up, you know? And I was like, this is going to happen again, but this is going to happen here in America. America is going to go through a great famine and great cannibalism, and people are going to have this similar disease, or the exact disease, all right? And they're going to suffer this disease. When the Lord can make it to where you can go through heavy, that person can go through heavy famine, eat people, and still be hungry, you know, and they won't be satisfied. So we're coming into some serious times, a time like never before, okay? And I also want to bring out this precept, because this event is going to happen again, all right? And this is also Deuteronomy 28 curse.
I got that.
You got that?
Yeah.
Bring out the Deuteronomy 28 curse, Bobby.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 53. And, you know, us Israelites are under this curse, these curses, because that's how you identify who are the true Hebrew Israelites. So you can go into the blessings and the curses. But we're about to bring out this curse right here.
Yeah.
Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 53.
Mm-hmm.
And thou shalt eat the fruit of thine own body,
mm-hmm.
the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which Yahweh Shem Yahshua thy power have given thee, in the siege and in the straitness wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee. And we're under subjection to our enemies right now in this kingdom. And according to Revelation chapter 12, verse 12, the devil shall come down with great wrath, which is the man that's in rulership right now, according to Job chapter 9, verse 24. The earth is given to the hands of the wicked. Mm-hmm. So that's Esau, Edom, man, the so-called white man.
God. While all this happens, the elites are going to be in their bunkers while all this happens. When people have civil war and on the soils of Babylon the Great, it's going to be civil war. It's going to be race wars. It's going to be murder, rape, and robbing. It's going to be cannibalism at an all-time high. Violence, kidnappings, ransoms, you know, human farms, or human farms, man. Sex trafficking out at an all-time high. You know, it's gonna be crazy out here. It's gonna be lawlessness all over the United States very soon, man. And one of the craziest things is what we're bringing out. It's the cannibalism.
God.
There is a huge toll if you eat people, man. It's gonna F up your body. And if you eat people, you have no faith, man, in the Lord. You have no faith. And pray that the Lord have mercy on you, so He can feed you something, you know, He can feed you something convenient for you in those days. You know, there's people stocking up right now as we speak at a nice little bunker or some sort of building, you know, and they might not be there for them to eat or to use those products. It could be meant for you if you are part of the elect of the 144,000, man. If you are part of the elect of the nation of Israel, you can get to those goods, and the Lord can lead you to those goods and take care of you and whoever's with you, or take care of you and your family, man, you know. But this right here is very serious, because what, there's gonna be no medical attention when these things happen. So imagine someone going through this neurological disorder of the Kuru disease, you know what I'm saying? It's incurable, you know. It's gonna make them start going crazy, like zombie-like, you know. And we must know these things. We must get into detail of these things, because you don't want to be that person that get caught up to that snare and eat some weird behind meat and find out it's one of your neighbors down the street. You feel me? Yeah, you don't want to be that guy, you know. But bring out that precept again of Deuteronomy 28.
Come on, let me grab it real quick.
Yeah, Bob Cashel. Come on. And then after that, I'm going to get 2 Kings chapter 6.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 53. And thou shalt eat the fruit of thine own body, the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which Yahweh Shimei thy power hath given thee, in the siege and in the straitness wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee.
Caught in the siege and the greatness, man. So the
straitness,
huh?
Straitness.
Yeah, the siege and the
difficulty.
You had difficulties, like that. As the scripture says, a man shall desire to go into the city and he can't. You know what I'm saying? You know, roughly paraphrasing. Let's get that real quick. I would rather grab it than to roughly paraphrase it. So I believe that's 2 Ezra 16. I don't know, that's 15. It's lucky. 2 Ezra chapter 15 verse 17. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able, because they're going to start shutting down cities from you entering from one city to the next. So people are going to be sieged. Guess what? If there's nothing coming in and nothing going out, guess what? People are going to start to kill each other, eat each other, do whatever to each other, right? Unless you had, you know, the MOTB, all right? Which is a soon coming event after these jabs, you know? So we're going to witness these times within our lifetime regardless, and it's going to be very, 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 very difficult. And that's where we must trust in the Lord. All right, we must trust in the Lord that he will feed us, that he will clothe us, and to look after us. We must have complete 144% faith that he can do that for us. 2 Ezra 15 verse 17, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. And that's going to be coming soon. All right. But I'm going to bring out this precept of 2 Kings.
Go on, chapter 6, verse 25.
Come on. I'm going to start at verse 24.
Come on.
2 Kings, chapter 6, verse 24. And it came to pass after this that Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, gathered all his hosts and went up and besieged Samaria. And there was a great famine in Samaria, and behold, they besieged it, until an ass's head was sold for 40 pieces of silver, and the forepart of a calf of dove's dung for 5 pieces of silver. It got so bad, they started selling. So when the soldiers of Samaria, you know, blocked all the exits, people went from having food to selling a donkey's head, an ass's head, for 40 pieces of silver, and the fourth part of a cab of dove's dung, so bird poop, for 5 pieces of silver. it's gonna get that bad out here. Just like what Brother Ball, you know, like Brother Ball, from this camp, Prophets in Babylon, he had a dream that people, like a man threw up, and people ran to the throw up and tried to eat the man's throw up, while the man was trying to pick up and eat his throw up again. That's how bad it's going to be, right? That's bad. Verse 26, and as the king of Israel was passing upon the wall, there cried a woman unto him, saying, "Help, my lord, O king." And he said, "If Yahweh Shemashah do not help thee, when shall I help thee? Out of the barn floor, or out of the wine press?" And the king said unto her, "What aileth thee?" And she answered, "This woman said unto me, Give thy son that we may eat him today, and we will eat my son tomorrow." That is wild, man. He said, "This woman said unto me, Give thy son that we may eat him today, and we will eat my son tomorrow." That's how bad it's going to get, but 100 times worse in America. And people are going to get that neurological disorder of Kuru within their system, of eating dead corpse of other people's, people are going to be eating each other's dead corpse to sustain themselves, but realizing they're going to destroy themselves even more by eating dead people. Right? Verse 29, it says, "So we boiled my son and did eat him. And I said unto her, On the next day, give thy son that we may eat him. And she have hid her son." You know, it's going to get so crazy, man. People are going to be hiding their kids, or they're going to be eating their kids. Or a group of people within that city is going to eat that one kid and eat the next person the next day. It's going to be crazy out here, man. That's where we must need salvation. Through Yahweh Shai, we have to have salvation, man. All right? We have to have salvation in these last days. We need salvation. We need salvation through the spirit power of Yahweh Shai, man. Because it's going to get really bad out here. All right? And they put in all these chemicals within these genetically modified foods, altering, putting all these chemicals within the food to make people more hungry than usual. You know, that high fructose corn syrup and all kinds of weird chemicals, trisodium phosphate and cinnamon toast crunch. Like, all these crazy stuff that's in the cereal and all these drugs within the food is going to make you drive, it's going to drive you crazy when you don't eat for a week. Right? So,
come. And I got to preach up real quick.
Go ahead.
With what the brother was talking about with this famine coming, like, some people can't see it because, you know, they're blinded by how cheap the goods and stuff is, like McDonald's, fast food, how convenient these cities are for the people. They don't really think that it's a problem to them, but once they block out these, you know, cities and towns and isolate everybody, all right, then you're going to see that there's a cutoff of supply, man. And we already see shortage of food truck drivers, all right? People are able to bring in supplies. We see that up in Canada with the protests, the truckers' protests. That's an example of, you know, trucks not bringing in supplies, man. And businesses are losing money towards that. But going into 2 Ezra chapter 16, verse 21, it says, "Behold, victuals," which are goods, all right, stocks, supplies, all right, "victuals shall be so good, cheap upon earth, that they should think themselves to be in good case.
Mm-hmm.
But even then shall evils grow upon earth, sword, famine, and great confusion." See, evil shall grow upon earth. So you might think that it's bad now. It's going to increasingly get worse, man. This is not a time for partying, man. We see that spirit right now strong. You know, in the end times. This is the end times right now. It says people was marrying and giving in marriage, you mm-hmm. know, partying, all right? Like in the days of Noah, man, all right? Continuing verse 22, it says, "For many of them that dwell upon earth shall perish of famine, and the other that escape the hunger shall the sword destroy." And the mm-hmm. sword goes into weaponry, man. The weapons, all right? you know, Esau coming down with that great wrath, man. All right. And it's worse to die of famine than of sword, going into Lamentation chapter 4, verse 9. And I can bring that out as well. But the people, you know, will die of hunger, many. All right. You know, this world is made for many, but the world to come is for a few, which is for the elect, man. All right. So let me grab Lamentation chapter 4, verse 9 real quick. And that also goes into cannibalism as well. This is the book of Lamentation chapter 4, verse 9. It says, they that be slain with the sword are better than they that be slain with hunger. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's a worse death to die of hunger, man. And it even says that if you escape the hunger, you know, let's say you did, which was, you know, you had a lot of pain. You should be in a lot of pain. You know, the sword will destroy you, man. If you're not one of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua's men, man, you know, his elect, actually, you know, the 1/3. All right. And the 144,000 elect men. Okay.
That's right.
If you're not of his people, if he's not with you, then that means he's against you.
Calm, okay? Man. And the sword, it's like the sword can be a quick death. You would rather go through a quick death than a slow death.
Calm.
You know what I'm saying? Like the sting of death, you know what I'm saying? I remember the Elder Kazakh, he was mentioning the sting of death. He said it's painful when you die. You know, and he mentioned brothers who were in combat when they used to be in the military and they seen people die. You know what I'm saying? They saw people die in front of their eyes and they seen that it was painful when they were dying. You know what I'm saying? We're going to see that ourselves. You know what I'm saying? We're going to see that ourselves we're going to see that for ourselves in 4K Ultra.
Calm.
You know what I'm saying? So we're going to literally see people die and we're going to see the sting of death with a lot of people.
Calm.
You know what I'm saying? And you're going to see how painful it is when the spirit leaves their body. But the scripture says right there, it said, what? Repeat again.
Lamentations chapter 4, verse 9. They that be slain with the sword mm-hmm. are better than they that be slain with hunger.
So it's better for you to be slain by the sword than you be slain with hunger. You know what I'm saying? When you struggle with hunger, man. Because hunger, first it eats the fat, then it eats your muscles, and then it starts eating everything inside of your body. And then all the way down to your bones. And after that, and then you're done for, man. And that's painful, man. You feel me?
But the sword is a quicker death. Continuing, it says, for these pine away. So if you bleed out, you know, you'll die quick. Mm-hmm. All right? Stricken through for want of the fruits of the field. And that will be a mental battle, man. When you're hungry, all right, you'll be wanting food, man. Mm-hmm. Your body would want it. So you'll be plagued, man, by hunger pains.
Yeah, man. And you'll be hallucinated. And then you'll see somebody and it look like a piece of chicken from KFC, you know what I'm saying, or a hot dog.
You eat them, hey, you can get high chance of getting that Kuru disease.
Absolutely,
man. And that will make it worse for you.
Yes, you're gonna be starting having seizures and foaming out the mouth because the prions, the protein prions, will multiply within your body. You know what I'm saying, and it's gonna cause you to have seizures. It's gonna cause you not to function correctly. You know, your coordination won't be correct. You're gonna start shaking, just like those people in the movie of the Book of Eli when it was shaking, like their hands were shaking and they couldn't stand still.
Gone. You know?
It's gonna be just like that in these last days, man.
Gone.
And you will know who eats people in those days.
Gone. And we're going to continue real quick with verse 10. Mm-hmm. It says, the hands of the pitiful woman mm-hmm. have sodden their own children. Mm. They were their meat and the destruction of the daughter of my people.
Come.
So, you know, the woman, you know, eating her own children because what? She's the weaker vessel, man. Come. She's not, you know, in the time that we're coming in, you know, women lack faith really, you know, on a spiritual level because the head of every man is Yahweh Shah Mashiach.
Absolutely.
And that's a spiritual sense because Yahweh Shah, you know, he gave us the Rakah Kodash, man. And that's wisdom. All right. The women's head will be the man. So the man is her leader, man. So in the times we're coming to, you're going to see a lot of women flock to the men of Yahweh Shah Mashiach, man, because they're going to be that comfort, you know. But the problem with this script, I mean, the thing about this scripture is that women are going to be weakened by this hunger, you know, by the famine, man. You're going to see them eating their own kids. And we went into 2 Kings chapter 6 also showing you that the decision that women make when they're in a situation of famine.
Yeah, and they make trouble, in trouble, they make haste in the time of trouble. Like, they make haste, like they'll do anything for a piece of bread. They'll do anything. They will literally leave their husband, you know, and get their cheeks clapped for some,
food or anything, yeah, money.
For some honey buns or anything.
Anything. They'll give it up quick, man.
Yeah, they'll give it up quick and leave their kids and leave their husband. Hey, man, history repeats itself. You know what I'm saying? And right now, we're just keeping it real, man. We're keeping it real. Like, a PG-13. You feel me? Like, we don't have to get all, you know, detailed and
calm.
You know what I'm saying? But we're telling the truth, man.
What we seen it today with that one woman, when the dude brought out money, she would mess with him. You know, we seen it on the video. And that's right now. With no difficulties. No, you know, you're not pushed in a life or death situation, kind of, you know. So imagine when it's famine and you're starving now. You know, these women right now would do anything for money.
Absolutely.
So imagine when, you know, you need food, man.
And if going to that word sada, it means to boil. All right. And I was watching a small little documentary of the cruel disease, and the woman was like, the narrator was like, he said, women and children will eat more dead corpse than the man. You know what I'm saying? Because women are the weaker vessel, right? And that precept that we just brought out, that the women sodden the children. And if going towards sodden means to boil. So they'll literally, I'm hungry. And they'll do anything to get something to eat. So if it has to be their child, they will eat it. Like eat their child. You know? And that was in the ancient days. That was in the Babylonian captivity in the book of Lamentations with the prophet Jeremiah. So how much more in these days?
Because these evils are going to grow upon this earth, man. And it's going to be great, you know, troubles and great tribulations, man. Great everything. This is Babylon the Great, man. So it's going to be great everything. The Most High is going to show his power, you know, all the way. It's going to be greater than Egypt's time. All right? Because this place is spiritually known as Egypt and Sodom.
That's right. Yeah, Revelations 11 and 8.
Come on. So imagine what happened in Egypt. You know, all these plagues that happened in Egypt, it's going to be on a greater scale here.
And what I mentioned about the Babylonian captivity, when they were seized and started eating the people, you know, America is also compared to Babylon, according to Isaiah 47:1. It's mentioned as the daughter of Babylon, right? It's taking the customs of ancient Babylon, taking the customs of Egypt, taking the customs of Sodom and Gomorrah, and also taking the customs of Edom, right? So all these places, all these wicked places, you know, America is compared to those places, but 100 times worse. And it's gonna be a time like never before, according to Jeremiah chapter 30:7. Right? But let's grab that last precept, man.
I got some Matthew real quick.
Matthew chapter 6. Beautiful.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat, or what ye shall drink. Nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? So that's, Yahweh Shai talking to his disciples, and the believers, He's saying that if you believe that the Most High got you, man, he's gonna do far exceeding than what you need, man. Because he knows what you need before you even ask of him. So when you pray, that's showing your faith to the Most High for things to be delivered out of troubles, to have him provide for you, nourish you, and not trusting your enemy, man.
That's right.
Because in the times we're coming in, the enemy's going to cut off all this supply, man, that he's been giving us. Mm-hmm. And the things that he's been giving us is GMO foods and low-quality foods anyways.
Yeah, and bad city water.
Con. So it's like we're tired of putting all our putting any support, like having this man support us, man. We want Yahweh Shemal Shah to support us, man. We're coming into these times where we're gonna need spiritual divine intervention, man. All right? We're gonna need the angels, you know, Yahweh Shemal Shah to send angels to feed us, all right? To keep us you know, not in any hunger pains, any troubles, any anguish, you know, to comfort us, man. And it starts with this word. It says comfort one another with these words. Mm-hmm. So these words, you know, coming out, it's saying to have faith, man. Believe, all right, that the Most High will feed you, man. He feeds the animals that you see out, all right, and about. So, and they don't reap nor sow, man. They don't sow nor reap, man, into barns of food. So don't just keep the faith, man. That's what it's all about. Your belief in Yahweh Shemal Shah, man.
Come. You know, and as the scripture says, my servant shall eat, but you shall be hungry. My servant shall drink, but, you know, but you shall be thirsty.
Come, I'm going to bring that out too.
Yeah, bring that out, and then we'll end on that.
Come. And see, you got to understand, it says servants. The servants of Yahweh Shemal Shah, the ones that's doing this work, man. That's what a servant is, man. Not ones that's fucking being a slave for Esau, you know, and then just, you know, not considering the Most High, man. That's not a servant to Yahweh Shemal Shah, the Heavenly Father, the Almighty. We're going to bring out this, though, real quick.
Con. You know, I'm going to bring this out, and then you bring that out. Amos chapter 3, verse 6. Shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and the people not be afraid? Shall there be evil in a city, and Yahweh Shemal Shah have not done it? Surely the Lord, Yahweh Shemal Shah, will do nothing but revealeth his secrets unto his servants, the prophets.
Calm.
Right?
Calm.
So he's revealing more things to us in these last days. What? So we can fear him more and to trust in him more, and so we can be protected by the angels, man, according to Psalms 34:7.
Calm.
The angels are kindled around about those who fear thee. You want that hedge. You want that protection.
Calm.
So the Lord can sustain you from all these evils that are about to come here on earth. All these plagues, man.
God.
Right? And he's only showing the secrets to the servants, the prophets.
God.
All right, go ahead, King.
There's the book of Isaiah, chapter 65, verse 13. Therefore, thus saith Yahweh Shemal Shah, behold, my servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, my servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
Behold, my servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed.
God.
So it's the things are going to flip, you know. Right now, all the brothers, you know, and sisters that believe in Yahweh Shemal Shah, we going through, you know, troubles and tribulations. But guess what? The roles are going to flip. We're going to see a change, man. Esau's going to lose his power, and it's going to be stripped down like lightning falleth from the sky quick. And then the Hebrew Israelite man that's on the bottom, that's been on the bottom for so long, is going to rise to the top, man. And that's Yahweh Shemal Shah's people, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Verse 14, it says, behold, my servants shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart, and ye shall howl for vexation of spirit. See, we're vexing this society. We want to see this place destroyed, man. But guess what? The road's going to flip. You two-thirds that's enjoying this place, all right? You're going to have to perish with this place as well, man, and come back and be reborn in the kingdom, man. Because this is a separation. Being a holy people to Yahweh Shemal Shah is to be separate. To not partake in this world. This world is enmity with the Most High, man. All right? Because it's full of wickedness. All right? So, we're serving Yahweh Shemal Shah, all you brothers and sisters that doing the work and pleasing the Most High, man, doing the things that the Most High asked for, charity, loving the brothers, loving the Most High, you know, keeping the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of your ability, mm-hmm. Keep it going, you know. Keep the faith, keep the belief. And if you're new and you're listening, believe in Yahweh Shemal Shah, man, He loves you if you if you have faith.
That's right.
That means you're an Israelite, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it starts with the names, man, because it says the fear. So how can you fear somebody if you don't know who they are? Build your personal relationship with the Most High, man. Pray without ceasing.
Come, Psalms 111:10, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Come. So the names are very important, man, especially in the times we're coming in.
That's right. We need the names. Yahweh Shai. Okay. So I hope this class was edifying to the elect. Call Allah.
Yeah, how will Bashim Yahshabash Makakadash?
If this was edifying to you, it's edifying to the elect. Till next time we say Shalom.
Shalom.
DTA Abba.
Abba Baba soon.